guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. If you guys have a BMW that does not start, I'm talking about any BMW, guys. Stay with us, we will discuss what you need to check and what you need to know and how you can probably fix that super easy. Now, we have a BMW 46, which is the 3 series, but the procedure will be the same for 3, 5 series, E60, 7 series, as well X3, X5, quite a few BMWs, guys. What you need to look for. Now, I'll demonstrate how this one doesn't start and we'll continue, but before we do that, let me tell you guys, we'll have more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop, because our mission, guys, is to save you as much money as we can. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel, like the video and leave a comment below. Let us know what you think or if the video was helpful. So let's go ahead and start on it now. So let me show you guys how it doesn't start this 3 series right here. I have the key in. Nothing, guys. I'll try again. Nothing. So what's causing that now? Okay, let me explain a few things to you now. First, guys, you need to check if your fuel pump is working. We'll show you how to do that. Second, you need to check ignition coils, if you're getting spark and all that. But what about the fuel pump? Fuel pump usually, guys, on BMW, when you turn the key on, the ignition without starting the car, okay, to where you have the lights on, you're going to hear the fuel pump running. Okay, it will be running right under the rear seat. Most of the BMWs, the pump will be there, and some have two sending units. So, by standing in front of the rear tire, kind of like stay out of the car, so somebody doesn't roll it on you, but if we have a person, okay, that's going to turn the ignition on and off, okay, you're going to hear the pump for about 2 seconds and you'll go away. Listen now. Okay, that's a fuel pump. Let's go again. That's a fuel pump, guys. So, why the car is not starting? Okay, first you need to check fuel. It could be a fuel pump, guys. So check the fuse for the fuel pump. If you hear your pump running, that's fine. It means the fuel pump is good, most likely. Probably 10% chance that it's making a noise, but it's not building enough pressure. It's possible, but not very often. Now, even if the fuel pump is running, but your fuel filter is clogged up, the car may not start. But in most of the cases, 9 out of 10 cases, when the filter is plugged up really bad, the car will still start, but it will die. It will start for a little bit. So probably it's not that. What else it could be, guys? Your fuel injectors. Fuel injectors, guys, are controlled by a fuse as well. And sometimes a relay. Check the fuse and the relay for the fuel injectors, because even if the pump works but the injectors do not, what's going to happen? You will not spray fuel inside the engine and the engine will not start. So if all that is good, guys, you need to check ignition coils. And on BMWs, okay, usually that's 6-cylinder, under that cover you'll find your ignition coils. You have 2 ground wires. Check the ground wires to make sure that they're fine. Otherwise, if you don't have ground, your ignition coils will not work. Next, guys, on most 3 series, even the new one, the E90s and all that stuff, your fuse box will be located, okay, in the glove box. Okay, let me open the door so I can show you quick. Okay, right here, I'm going to open these things. And this, guys, is your fuse box. But you have hidden relays, most often, behind your glove box. You will need to remove your glove box, especially on E46. The fuel pump relays here and all that stuff. You have, guys, quite important relays here for the air conditioner and things like that. Also, guys, okay, if that is good, you sometimes have, guys, hidden fuses under the carpet right here. And the only way to do that is remove the seat and remove the carpet on this side so you can get to it. You might have a fuse for a starter there, or you may have a fuse for the engine computer. On this BMW here now, okay, let me show you guys what we're going to do. First thing, always check relays and fuses. That's the easiest thing. Second, you're going to start looking at crankshaft position sensor, because if it's bad, the car will not start. But here we have a fuse box. And that fuse box, okay, has only 4 screws. 1, 2, 3, 4. We get those loose, remove it. And here, guys, you're going to have your engine computer, transmission computer, a few relays that are not so important. But, okay, you can see here that says motor. This is the engine management fuses, guys. That's something super important here on BMW. So you want to go ahead, remove that. Okay, here you have one clip that you spread out and you pull it out. Now, that fuse box contains regular fuses, guys. Okay, and I'm going to open it for you and show you. They're just regular size, standard size fuses. Okay, let me just open it perfect. Okay, like that. And you can just pull them out, check them if you need to. And in our case, guys, we have a bad fuse, okay, for the engine computer. Okay, now, engine computer fuse, and the one for the crankshaft position sensor. And we're going to replace this one now. Okay, I'm going to replace it. I checked all of them, this one was bad. Put it together now. Put it here, make sure it contacts and all that stuff. Close that fuse box now. Okay, perfect, and I'll go inside now. Okay, and I'm going to see if that car is going to start. Every time you mess with the engine management fuses, engine computer, all that stuff, I would recommend to disconnect your car battery before you do that so you don't burn anything. And if still doesn't start, it could be, guys, bad immobilizer, the key is going bad, or the car forgot it. Could be quite a few scenarios, but always check your fuses and your relays for fuel pump, ignition coils, crankshaft position sensor, and engine computer first. And we fire, guys, right up, not even engine light on. So, that took care of our problem. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and see you guys next time.